Hello, this is Ben Bithorpe reporting from AKS Stories, and I'll be your host for In the Camp 3. We are taking a look at Warhammer Club.
This is Ben Bithorpe reporting from AKS Stories, and I'm here today with Kelly Quigley, who is a member of Warhammer Club. So, what do you do in Warhammer?
Well, basically, I like to think of it as really advanced chess, but with guns, knives, swords and whatnot. And tanks. What you do is, basically, today in this round, we have four teams of two, okay, one in each corner, and basically your aim is to try and get to the top of the castle.
So, next question, Cody. Have you enticed New Year 7 into coming into this club?
Yes, we have. We've got about 15 signing up, and they recently are coming next Wednesday, and we're going to try and move the time so it's Monday, Wednesday and Friday.
So, for our final question today, Cody, what direction do you see Warhammer going in the next couple of months and years?
Well, by lots of things, forward, because of these new pieces of the map and the more and more Year 7s that are signing up. And we'll hopefully stay for until Year 9 at least. We've also got new characters and new gameplay, so we now have different options for when you're playing.
That sounds great. Thank you very much.
Next, we'll be interviewing Sam Southern on how he's become head boy and the journey towards it.
So, I'm here with Sam Southern, who is the new head boy. Why do you think you have been chosen to be the head boy?
I think the school has recognised everything I've done for it over the years, and it will reward me for all the effort, the time I've put in. I think they recognise that I'll do a good job, and that I'll, continue to serve in a way that's beneficial to the school.
And have you enjoyed it so far?
I've definitely enjoyed it. The obvious factors that people see, I think, every day is the fact that we just sit in the front of assembly, but there's a lot more to it than that. But it's been fun.
But do you also feel that there's some pressure?
Yeah, definitely. There's definitely some pressures. It would be ridiculous if there weren't. But I don't think it's anything that I can't handle going forward, so.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.
So, why do you think you've been chosen to be a head girl?
Well, I think the school recognised all the hard work I put into school, but also I think they feel like I was probably approachable from other students. Yeah.
And what things have you got involved in so far while being head girl?
Well, quite a lot. So, I was already the service pillar leader for Round Square, so I'm heavily involved in AKS Action. And the Round Square Bring Me Sunshine group as well. We've done lots of school council meetings as well, which has been quite cool, organising, all that kind of thing. Yeah.
Great. So, what do you plan to do going forward as head girl?
Okay. Well, one of the main things that I'm planning on doing is trying to raise awareness of dementia. Obviously, quite a lot of people already know what dementia is, but they don't realise really what it involves and like the different types of dementia, how the people are cared for and what it's actually like for the family of the patient who's got dementia and what the person who's got dementia might actually be feeling. That's one of the main things I'm doing this year. And then also the role of service as well.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.
Next, Ben Bithorpe will be interviewing Daniel, a New Year 7 student at AKS.
Yeah. We're going to interview him on the New Year 7s and the new council members. So, do you like your New Year 7?
I think they're a good group of people.
Do you think that they work well?
Yeah, they do.
And do you think that they'll be a good addition to the school?
Probably.
So now some questions about the council. Who is your council rep?
Cameron McIntyre.
Do you think he works well with the council?
He does.
And do you think the New Year 7s will work well with the council?
Yeah, I've heard good reports about them.
Thank you. We have a new modern foreign languages teacher, Mrs. Mather. So, we thought we'd interview her on the bench about something she's done in the past.
Hello, this is Ben Bithorpe reporting from AKS Stories. And I'm here today with Mrs. Mather. As our new teacher of modern foreign languages, we'd like to know something about her. So, as a bit of previous catch-up, we seem to have learned that you have a bit of history with cricket. Could you tell us some more about this?
Well, I can do, and you're wearing a very famous hat.
I am.
This hat used to belong to one of the most famous cricketers of all time, a man called Gary Sobers, who became Sir Garfield Sobers. He was knighted by the Queen. And Gary Sobers came over to play in the Lancashire League in the 50s. And he was brought over by a man called Frank Worrell. And they had to have somewhere to stay when they practiced their cricket. So Gary Sobers lodged with my grandma for 3 years. He came over when he was 18 and he had his 21st birthday party with her. And I used to call him Uncle Gary. And why is he famous?
Well, he's the best all-round cricketer in the world.
Yeah, of all time. And he was the first to have to get six sixes in an over. And also, he had the highest run score in test cricket, which I think was only beaten by Brian Lara. So that's that. That's his hat. That's his scarf. And we've got a few bats as well, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, I just noticed at the bottom of your pile there something to do with skiing.
Yes. Now, this is here because that's something, another thing that I did years ago. Now, this company is called Ski Cordon Rouge, but it used to be called Red Guide Holidays. And for about 4 or 5 seasons, I worked in the French Alps and I worked as a chalet girl. And in the summertime, I worked in the south of France, looked after villas and cleaned swimming pools.
Wow, this is just amazing. There's so much to learn about. Thank you.
You're welcome. Anytime.
You're on.
So I'm here with Anna Kaluka, who is a new member of AKS Stories. So what have you done so far for AKS Stories?
Well, I've interviewed and I helped film.
Have you enjoyed it so far?
Yes.
And would you like to do things going forward with AKS Stories?
Yes.
Thank you for watching In The Can 3. We'll hope you tune in for the next one. Yeah.